Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to more WWE 2K16 Universe Mode. My name is BrendenPlayz. Before we get into this episode, major announcement regarding NXT. The NXT Championship will be on the line at Hell in a Cell in the pre-show. It'll be AJ Styles versus Apollo Crews. Who will walk away as NXT champ? We're going to find out in Hell in a Cell. So that will be available on YouTube. We're going to upload that as a separate video, and of course will be available on the live stream just before Hell in a Cell begins as well. As it stands right now, it looks as though Hell in a Cell is going to be on Saturday the 23rd of July. I know a lot of you guys have been wondering, so that's the date that is set right now at this stage. So it could change, but that's where we're looking at right now. This week on NXT, we have Austin Aries going one-on-one against Elias Sampson. We also have the team of Johnny Gargano and Tommaso Ciampa. Versus the Vaude Villains. That'll be a number one contenders match for the NXT Tag Team titles as well. Billie Kay goes one-on-one with Alexa Bliss. That should be a good contest between two of our emerging women here in NXT. We have AJ Styles, the champion, going one-on-one against Baron Corbin. Styles looks to prepare himself for his big match coming up. And this is a big one right here. It's a number one contenders match for the NXT Women's Championship. Carmella versus Nia Jax. So our two winners from last week will meet here tonight, with the winner facing Bayley at the next NXT TakeOver. Austin Aries gets the win over Elias Sampson. Billie Kay versus Alexa Bliss. It is going to be Billie Kay with a win there. Styles versus Corbin. AJ Styles gets the win as we move on to our tag team match. So an opportunity to be the next tag team contenders for the American Alpha is up for grabs here tonight. So we'll see and crown the next number one contenders to take them on at NXT TakeOver number 2, which will be taking place a couple weeks before Survivor Series and a couple weeks after Hell in a Cell. So smack bang in the middle of next month. So not too far away at all. And Gargano and Ciampa looking for a big match here tonight, a big win. Look, you know, straight in title contention and beating the American Alpha not too long ago either. Certainly will, you know, giving them a lot of confidence if they can get through the Vaude Villains here tonight and the belief that they need to perhaps win those tag team titles. Here are their opponents here tonight, the Vaude Villains. So this should be a good contest between these two teams. We've seen the Vaude Villains in amongst the top tier of the teams for quite some time here. Of course, the American Alpha defeating the Vaude Villains to win the tag titles all those months ago. So the Vaude Villains have been okay as of late. They've been a little bit lucky, a bit fortunate to have this opportunity here tonight. But they do, and they need to make the most of it. Now the fact that they have this chance, they need to make sure that they walk away as victors. So, the Vaude Villains versus Johnny Gargano and Tommaso Ciampa. It's going to be close. It's going to be hard to pick. But based off recent form and confidence alone, you'd have to say Gargano and Ciampa have the slight edge. But in terms of experience here in NXT, you know, definitely the Vaude Villains have that edge over the team of Gargano and Ciampa. There's a DDT there by Gargano. Fans like to refer to him as Johnny Wrestling, so we'll see what he can do here in this one with Aiden English. So a win against the American Alpha will certainly do them a lot of good, obviously. I mean, on the contrary, the Vaude Villains losing to the American Alpha when they did, they'll be out for a bit of revenge. Obviously, seeing what the American Alpha have been able to accomplish since becoming tag team champions, that could have well easily been the Vaude Villains. So the Vaude Villains probably a little bit annoyed with themselves that they didn't get that win on that occasion, and now perhaps looking to get a bit of revenge, trying to get themselves back in title contention, get themselves another opportunity at the American Alpha. Whereas Ciampa and Gargano, they're just trying to kind of sink their teeth into NXT a little bit, get their feet wet, just try to, you know, scope things out a bit, try and wonder who's the top teams here, you know, how good are they as a team. They're trying to figure all that out, and so far they've been very impressive, but obviously the bubble can burst at any time, and so it's a fair opportunity that perhaps this small little run that they're having of, you know, some wins and looking pretty good, it could kind of come crashing down at any time. So they have to be pretty careful about that. That's you know, if they do lose the American Alpha or the Vaude Villains here tonight, that they can recover from it, because some teams, they just can't seem to recover after taking a big loss. So let's hope that Gargano and Ciampa is not one of them. I think, realistically, Gargano and Ciampa probably need a few more months' experience before they are good enough to win and be tag team champions, but maybe they can fast-track themselves here. Win against the Lord Villains, win against American Alpha, they're right there. They have the titles, so there'll be a lot of pressure on them to be able to hang on to them. That's where they'll probably go wrong. That's probably where they will struggle to try and keep the titles for a long period of time. But at least they've opened up the doors and given themselves the best opportunity possible to win those titles, and they're doing pretty good right now. Simon Gotch, attempted suplex by Ciampa. Gotch now, after reversal, will sweep Ciampa off his feet. Down he goes. So just to kind of give you guys a bit more information on what's going on with the NXT Championship. Early in the show, obviously, announced it's going to be at Hell in a Cell on the pre-show. There will be a takeover between, like I said, 2 weeks after Hell in a Cell, 2 weeks before Survivor Series. So that's probably, what, a month away now? So there will be a takeover then, but there will be a title match at Hell in a Cell in the pre-show. So Styles versus Cruz, that will take place in the pre-show. So like I said, I'm going to stream it. So if you are coming along to the Twitch streams, and I believe, like I said, Saturday the 23rd, I believe it is, of July, same time as last time. Last time, would I stream at 2 p.m. or 5 p.m.? I don't remember. I think it might have been 2 p.m. So 2 p.m. Saturday. So the pre-show will take place maybe an hour or half an hour early, however long the match goes for. So you'll be able to watch on the pre-show, but I'll also will upload it separately as well to the channel, probably after the pre-show airs on my channel. I'll upload it, and you guys can check that out. If you are unable to watch Hell in a Cell on its stream, you'll be able to watch the pre-show and the Hell in a Cell pay-per-view, of course, on YouTube afterwards. So keep an eye out for that. Apollo Crews versus AJ Styles. It's been a good rivalry over the last few months between Styles, Samoa Joe, Itami, and Crews. So it's been a good back and forth rivalry between those four men. We'll see what Apollo Crews can do one-on-one against AJ Styles. Should be a good match, and it'll take place at Hell in a Cell in the pre-show. And also, I'll show some highlights during the Hell in a Cell pay-per-view as well. So if you perhaps are wanting to watch the stream but you missed the pre-show, you can also be up to date there whilst watching it. As Gargano gets put into the steel steps there by Aiden English, looking to continue that assault here to the outside. So Takeover's looking pretty good at the moment. We've got some big matches lined up for you. The tag team title opportunity here between one of these two teams. Later on in the show, we're going to find out whether or not Carmella or Nia Jax will take on our NXT Women's Champion Bayley for the championship. And probably most likely, the NXT champion will have to defend his championship against somebody. It might be Apollo Crews as the champion. Maybe AJ Styles will be looking for a rematch. Or maybe we'll see a new opponent, a new challenger for AJ Styles emerge after Hell in a Cell. Gotch has Gargano on the ropes. Simon Gotch with the boot right into the face. Taken down. Here's a chance. Drags him into the middle of the ring, rolls him over. Look out, he's a cover. Simon Gotch to advance to Takeover. Can't get it though. A kick out of two. And Gotch is going to look for the tag. He'll get it, and Aiden English will come in now. So Gargano and Aiden English again. This time they're in the ring. And this time Gargano. Oh, counter there by English. And now look out. DDT. A chance now for the cover and perhaps the win. Here it is. Presses down on top, and no, kick out of two. Thought he may have had him there, did Aiden English after that good DDT. Tempted uppercut, missing. Gargano tried to grab a hold of Aiden English as well. He missed. And now, look out, a bit of tag team work inbound. Gotch off the second, and the double axe handle onto the arm of Gargano. Now, look out. Gotch has some momentum going. The Vaudevillains on top here. Trouble now. Gargano in the corner. Look out. Bouncing off the turnbuckle. Down he goes. Gotch, I think he already had him in the middle of the ring. I don't think he was anywhere near the ropes, but he decided to position him a little bit better again, and that may have cost him. I think he underestimated himself there. I don't think Gargano was going to touch the ropes. I think he would have been okay. But Gotch making a mistake and probably costing him a chance to win it. Now,
attempted a fallaway slam or something along those lines, but he misses out because he goes headfirst into the mat, thanks to Gargano.
Now Ciampa back in the match. Gotch and Ciampa now. Simon Gotch with some big kicks right to the midsection of Ciampa. Ciampa turns him around, look out, and a back suplex by Tommaso Ciampa. Now with the cover, the leg is hooked. This is, could be it. No, a kick out. So the American Alpha, we've seen them being so, so impressive since winning those tag team titles. But one little slip up to Gargano and Ciampa, and all of a sudden, they're going to be in the title hunt, perhaps. They can win this match tonight, they'll be right there. And American Alpha, if they do take on Gargano and Ciampa, they're going to be very concerned after losing to them not too long ago. They're going to be pretty worried that they might not be able to get it done come takeover time. So it's going to be a big concern for them. The Vaudevillains, they've beaten them in the past, but the Vaudevillains, you get the feeling, have improved as a tag team. So another opportunity for the Vaudevillains. Well, maybe this time they'll be successful. Maybe this time they'll win those tag titles. The big boot into the corner there by Ciampa, and kick out of two again. Now Ciampa back to his feet. And look out, the drop kick into the back of that neck and the head region. Pinpoint perfection there by Ciampa. And now the knee right to the head. Simon Gotch probably needs to look for a tag, in my opinion. And he's going to bring Ciampa in the corner. And I think that's exactly what he's going to look for. No, Ciampa the counter. Not going to get the tag now. Ciampa, look out. Here we go, the powerbomb. Down he goes. That could be it right here. What's he trying to do now? He's trying to get off the second rope right near Aiden English. And that is that's a bad mistake. Let's be honest. That's a shocking error. I mean, Aiden English is right there. And you try and jump off the second rope. What is Aiden English going to do? Just let you do it? I mean, of course he's going to knock you off. Not sure what Ciampa was thinking there. Uh-oh, Simon Gotch. Oh, no. He's got him now. The shoulders are down. I thought Gotch was going to counter it. But Ciampa just kind of falls into it. And the shoulders are down. Ciampa had a chance to put Gotch away. English and Gargano both there to oversee things. Now they're after one another is Gargano and English. Gotch now has Ciampa in the corner. So a chance now for Ciampa to kind of capitalize here. Aiden English is nowhere to be found. Trying to get back to his feet, trying to get back to his corner. Now he's going to come after Gargano. And an arm drag. So chance for one of these two to capitalize. With a kind of, both of them distracted by the other partners. Gotch going for the cover. But the referee not happy that Aiden English was in the ring. Aiden English attacking Gargano regardless. The referee wanted English to get out of there. And he kind of faked it as though he was going to. But the referee decided to start counting when he wasn't out of the ring yet. Now attempted suplex. Connects. And look out. Ooh. Went for a DDT. Instead he connected with the rope rather than the mat. And Gargano landing pretty perfectly. That was pretty smooth. On the apron, he's right there, but he's not in the right corner of the ring to get the tag, though. And I think he might need to look for the tag. Ciampa's in some trouble here. Gargano might need to get to the corner to try and help his tag partner out. Trying to go for the scoop slam, missing out. And now, look out. Ciampa picks him up. The powerbomb into the double knees. Now, that could be it. Ciampa with his best shot. Is that it? Yes, it is. Gargano stopping English from breaking it up. And Gargano and Tommaso Ciampa walks away with the win. And that means they'll meet the American Alpha again. This time at NXT TakeOver number 2 for the NXT Tag Team Championships. What a win here tonight for Ciampa. And Gargano, a big, big win. And a confidence-building win as well. Now, they're ready. I think the win that they got a few weeks ago might have been more of a fluke. But a couple wins since. And all of a sudden, I think these two guys could be the real deal. A big match they'll have for the tag titles at TakeOver. They've got a bit under a month now to prepare. They'll need that time. But American Alpha, there are your opponents. And they're going to be very, very tough to beat. No doubt about that. Alrighty, so here is our number one contenders match for the Women's Championship here in NXT. And here comes Carmella, one of the two participants here tonight. Carmella, impressive last week, getting herself a victory. And all of a sudden now, she's found herself with an opportunity to become the next contender for Bayley's championship. Now, Carmella, we haven't seen too much of her in terms of showcasing her here in NXT, but some wins have come her way, and she's certainly been pretty impressive at times. So Carmella has a real chance to kind of stake her claim here and really cement herself as a top-tier woman here in NXT. Can she accomplish that? Well, only time will tell, but she has plenty of potential. There's no doubting her right here. So Carmella versus Nia Jax here tonight. This should be a close one. Nia Jax was pretty impressive last week. We have to admit that. So here she comes, Nia Jax. So Nia Jax, very good against Becky Lynch last week. And Carmella with a bit of an upset as well. So this should be a close one. I think probably the two unlikely winners meet here tonight from our two matches. I thought Nia Jax was a fair chance, but I thought maybe Becky Lynch might have edged her out. But unfortunately for Becky Lynch, she couldn't do that. Nia Jax's power was just too much to deal with. And Nia Jax finds herself in a really good position here to all of a sudden be taking on Bayley at TakeOver. And you'd have to say, if she does take on Bayley, it's a huge mismatch in terms of size. Certainly Nia Jax has a huge advantage, and she could definitely take care of Bayley. But can she take care of Carmella? We'll find out right now as this one gets underway. They'll lock up. And of course, Nia Jax with the advantage there in terms of size, power, and strength, taking down Carmella. So no doubt about it, Nia Jax, very good last week. We were pretty impressed with her performance against Becky Lynch. I thought we kind of saw Nia Jax kind of break out. You know, Nia Jax has been okay. She's had some wins, no doubt, but she hasn't really been the monster or the performer that we probably expected her to be. But now all of a sudden we see her, and I think all of a sudden we kind of feel and believe that she could be a champion at one point. She has the credentials, she's got the ability, and she's got the family lineage. Nia Jax has all the tools to really be successful here at NXT and perhaps be champion at one point. Carmella tossing Nia Jax down. So there's a bit of strength from Carmella. So Nia Jax has got it all. But is her inexperience going to be the key factor here? Is the fact that she hasn't been involved in too many high-profile big matches, is that where she's going to go wrong? I'm not sure. You know, will she find herself making easy errors, lazy mistakes? Is that where Nia Jax is going to go wrong? You know, she needs to try and make sure that she doesn't make any of these errors. It doesn't, you know, make any of these rookie mistakes, I guess you could say. But we'll see how she goes here. So far, so good against Carmella, who is holding her own, though, Carmella. And no surprise there. She's a great woman here at NXT. She's got a lot of great potential. And I think right now for Carmella, this is her opportunity here to break out and show us what she can do. Obviously, a bit of a win last week. You probably could argue that it might have been more of a fluke rather than a good performance. But we'll see how Carmella goes. She beats Nia Jax here tonight, then she'll get her opportunity at Bayley. And I would have to say the same thing for her. I think she would have cemented her place as a top-tier diva or woman, whatever you want to call them, here in NXT. So it's a real opportunity here for both women. Nia Jax down from behind. Sends down Carmella with a neck breaker. The knee went to the head and followed up with a neck breaker. Nice little combination there. And now dragging her into the middle of the ring, hoping to win this one and put this one away right now. Here's the cover, hooks the leg. The referee's right there in position. Carmella will kick out at two. Carmella, of course, been involved with Enzo and Cass over the past few months. And she's trying to kind of break out a little bit on her own. Enzo and Cass have done pretty well for themselves. Carmella has helped along the way. But Carmella's trying to just kind of break through and trying to cement her own place here at NXT. Show us what she can do in the ring. And a real chance right now to show us all that she can be a champion at one point. She is championship material. An elbow there by Nia Jax to Carmella. Nia Jax will send Carmella to the corner. And now here's trouble. Look out. Here's a steel ring post. Into the corner. And now Carmella, she's in trouble. Nia Jax getting a bit of a roll on here. Oh, turning into a bit of a powerbomb situation as well. Picking her up and dragging her all the way down. And again, the cover. Can't put her away though. She's fighting through. But it's tough times ahead for Carmella. And oh, the snapmare. Carmella now, can she stay in this match? Can she fight back through and beat Nia Jax here. It's such a difficult task to do. Nia Jax is such a behemoth here at NXT. She's such a monster. And for someone like Carmella, she can certainly get in the ring and fight. And there's no doubt about that. But trying to contend with a monster is such a difficult thing to do. And considering that Nia Jax is really unique in that aspect. Shoulders are down here. Nia Jax kicks out at one. Nia Jax is such a unique woman here at NXT. You know, you're not going to see too many Nia Jaxes walking around here in NXT, let's be honest. So when Carmella and a Bayley and a Becky Lynch and everyone else that faces Nia Jax, when they do get in the ring with her, it's such a different match to what they're perhaps used to. That's why Nia Jax is so difficult and so dangerous. Unless you kind of get in the ring with her on multiple occasions, you really don't know what to expect. You really don't know how to handle her power, her size, her strength. Carmella has her in the corner there. She's going to try and drag her off the top of the rope. She's going to be able to do it. What about that from Carmella? She's kind of just grabbed onto Nia Jax and fell off the top of the rope, and it worked out okay for her. Nia Jax went down. A headbutt there by Jax. So Carmella staying in it. And she's looking pretty good though. Carmella, you'd have to say if she wins here tonight, it's a bit of an upset. But she's looking as though she might be able to pull it off. The drop kick now to the back of Jax. Rolls her over. But Nia Jax though, uh-oh. The arm bouncing off the shoulder of Jax. Now she's got a hold of Carmella, picks her up. And there's the power of Jax. Just the knee right in the shoulder of Carmella. She could have held her up all night. That's how powerful and strong she is. Carmella able to get back to her feet though. Nia Jax is setting up for something big. Snapmare takedown. She couldn't quite get what she wanted, Nia Jax, and now she has to try and regroup. Probably frustrating her. Carmella receiving that knee right into the back, stretching her right back. There's a lot of pain right there. Those arms are not meant to go back that way. But Carmella trying to get back up to her feet. And now she breaks through, gets the elbow strike into the midsection of Jax. A right hand now. Turns around. Look out. Nia Jax. Oh, a rake of the back. And you don't see that one too often. It's not pretty, but it's effective. And that time she just slams her head right back down to the mat. And a full press now on top of her. And she tries to put her away. She can't do it though. And she kicks out at two again. Carmella, she's fighting. Attempted forearm strike there. Missing from Jax. Carmella's going to look to make her pay. And a back suplex. Now Carmella going to take the opportunity to take a bit of a breather. But that's where Carmella might be going wrong. Instead of trying to take a breather and recover and recuperate, she should have tried to stay on top of Nia Jax. And because of that, Jax was able to get back to her feet. Carmella, though, recovering. Or has she? She's got Jax on top of the rope. It looks as though... Uh-oh, she's going to go off the top of the rope again. Nia Jax in a bad way. A back suplex off the top. And Nia Jax is in real trouble because Carmella could be 3 seconds away from walking out as the number one contender for the NXT Women's Championship. A big shot there by Nia Jax. Jax now picks up. Oh, picks up Carmella, turning it into a Samoan drop. And that should be it right there. Here it is, the hook of the leg. Carmella's in trouble, but she'll kick out at two. Well, there you go. There's the resilience of Carmella on show. She's going to persevere and try and fight through the monster. Nia Jax here. A stop there by Jax. And Jax has her right where she wants her. Drops the elbow. Well, she might be looking for that leg drop. We know once she hits that leg drop, it is all over. Deciding against it. And now, oh, what about the German suplex from Carmella? Nia Jax has been tossed around this ring by Carmella, and you wouldn't think it's possible, but Carmella's showing us what she can do. She's really impressing us right now, and look out. Oh, Carmella just stretched on the back of Nia Jax, and down she goes. Nia Jax back to her feet, and she has to know that this is the time. This is the time, or it might be too late. I think Nia Jax is in some trouble. I think Carmella, for the most part, has got the better of her. Carmella has a real chance here to win this match if Nia Jax isn't careful. And oh, was that three? It was that three. The referee counting.
I think his hand hit the mat for three, but Carmella kicked out. He said it was a kick out. There's a spine buster. It might not matter. Count to three again, ref. Surely you can count to three. No, kick out. That time she kicked out with time to spare. The one before, I'm not sure. Well, now a referee, he can't see when someone grabs the ropes. He's blind. Now he can't hear things. Now he can't even count to three. I mean, what the hell can this referee do? I mean, when are we going to get a new ref? When are we going to get a new ref? I mean, come on. Surely we could fit that in the budget. Nia Jax, though. Going to be put on the top rope again. Carmella's gone to this a few times here tonight. Is it going to work out for the third time? I think it might. She's going to go for that hip toss off the top again. And it's worked out really well for her. The referee, he's distracted by something shiny in the crowd. But he turns around, realizes there's a cover. And that may have cost Carmella from winning this match. A slight delay there by the referee. And that could have been the difference between a two and a three count. Carmella now. Nia Jax tries to come after and Carmella turns into a hurricane runner. Down goes Jax. Carmella, she's got this match won, surely. She is on fire right now. Carmella and Nia Jax putting on a clinic. Can Carmella finish the job? She's got so close. She just has to hit one more big move, you'd think, and try and put Nia Jax away. Jax now picks her up. Uh-oh, look out. And just kind of drilling the shoulder into Carmella up top there. Rolls her over. Look out! Leg drop! Drops the leg. And Carmella, her dreams have just been crushed by Nia Jax. Well, what about that? Nia Jax went from pretty much losing the match to turning it all around, winning the matchup, and putting Carmella away. Well, that was close. Honestly, I thought for sure that Carmella was going to probably pull out the victory there. I would have thought an upset was going to happen here tonight. But Nia Jax barely scrapes through. It's not the win she wanted to show and Bayley that she's ready for the title. It's certainly not. But a win is a win. She'll meet Bayley at TakeOver. Nia Jax versus Bayley for the NXT Women's Championship. It's going to happen. Let's hope that Nia Jax can deliver a better performance than she did tonight. Not her best at all, but a win is a win. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you again for joining us for another episode of NXT. Hope you guys enjoyed today's episode. If you did, let's shoot for a big goal. Let's try for something crazy. Let's go for 200 likes. Can we hit 200 likes on this episode? If we hit 200 likes, I will upload another episode of Universe Mode. As soon as this video hits 200 likes, I'm going to get ready. I'm going to make a video. I'm going to upload this bad boy for you. Can we do it? 200 likes. Getting close to Hell in a Cell, guys. Like I said, looks like it's going to be happening on Saturday, July 23rd. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Check out the social medias. Check out the Patreon page to help support me. Keep up to date with Hell in a Cell by checking out the website, BrendenPlayz.com, and clicking the Hell in a Cell page. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and I'll see you all next video.